Nintendo just released a surprise mini direct, and it was packed with new game announcements, release dates, and updates for some of the biggest games out now. Let's check out the highlights. The Switch's most recent big release is Animal Crossing New Horizons, and it's getting a Bunny Day update in early April. Bunny Day is the series equivalent to Easter, and it runs from April 1st through the 12th. You'll be visited by Zipper T. Bunny, who challenges you to find all of his hidden eggs across your island. We also got word on the next Super Smash Bros. Character. Fighter Pass 2's first edition will be a character from ARMS, and they'll be available in June. Nintendo didn't say who the ARMS representative was, but since Springman is already in Ultimate as an assist trophy, my money is on Ribbon Girl. As part of the tease, ARMS is also getting a free trial period. Nintendo Switch Online members can play the game for free, starting today through April 6th. Bravely Default 2 is coming in 2020, but its eShop demo is also available today. That's not all you can jump into right now. Ring Fit Adventure is also getting an update. This one includes new language options for the ring, and the new jogging option lets you run through the levels without any combat encounters. There's also a brand new game out today on Switch, Panzer Dragoon Remake. It's a Switch console exclusive for now. Of course, more games are on the horizon too. The Bioshock Collection, Borderlands Collection, and XCOM 2 Collection will all launch on May 29th. Catherine Full Body arrives on July 7th, and a quick montage showed Burnout Paradise Remastered coming this year too. Let's wrap up the same way the Direct did, with Pokémon Sword and Shield. We got some new info on the first expansion, Isle of Armor, specifically on the island's dojo. Here, you'll be given the new legendary Pokémon Kubfu. Kubfu evolves into Urshifu, which has two possible forms, the Dark-type Single Strike style and the Water-type Rapid Strike style. Once you've obtained Kubfu, you can choose to enter either the Tower of Darkness or the Tower of Waters. Complete the challenge, and Kubfu will evolve into its respective Urshifu form. The three starters also gain Gigantamax forms on the Isle of Armor. Rillaboom can use G-Max Drum Solo, Cinderace learns G-Max Fireball, and Inteleon gets G-Max Hydro Snipe. These attacks are more powerful than Dynamax moves, and they ignore enemy abilities. So that's a ton of stuff, but the Nintendo Direct had even more to comb through. GameSpot has more info on some other Switch games you can start playing today.